morning, everybody. I hope you're having a lovely setup. And I'm here with Minister Marc Hansen at the TV show section of ICT Spring. Marc Hansen, you are Minister, amongst other things, for digitalisation. So in that role, COVID-19, it really seemed to accelerate the digitalisation of so many processes. What did you observe?
Yeah, in fact, it was a booster, the pandemic, for the digital world here in Luxembourg, also concerning e-government. I think before COVID-19, just to tell you, we had at our portal, mygische.lu, we had about 350,000 transmissions, so administrative procedures done by citizens or companies. And during the year 2021, we had 3.8 million transmissions. You see really an increase, and it was, of course, it was administrative procedures linked to COVID-19, like the vaccination portal or others, but we had also an increase of all the procedures not related to COVID-19. So it was a real boost. And on the other hand, being the Minister for Civil Service, we had also a boost, as everybody, concerning the Home Office. Before the pandemic, we had for the civil servants a project with 169 persons being in the Home Office. So it was a pilot. After the COVID-19, we had thousands of people being in the Home Office, not only for the civil service, but we had from one day to the other all the pupils, the teachers, the civil servants turning to Home Office. And I think it will remain one of our main topics, also the Home Office in the civil service in the country. And these are just two cases to show you how the digitalization was boosted and pushed. And that we had, of course, some lessons learned that we have built on all the experience that we had during the COVID-19 to improve our relationship to the companies, to the citizens, and to work on that one during the next years.
So an absolute step change there, with so many of these processes staying in place now as we move forward.
Yeah.
Now, we're sitting here in ICT Springs, so not talking to the audience I'm about to talk about, but amongst the population, there's sometimes some digital mistrust. As Minister Delegate for Digitalisation, how do you address any digital mistrust?
Yeah, I would say that perhaps the word mistrust is not really appropriate. We had, before the pandemic, we had an opinion survey done, and we had the return that the majority of the people, they really believed in the digitalization, that it could make their life, their work easier. And they trusted, in fact, the state, and they trusted what we did. So they said that the public service was well prepared for the digitalization. That was already before the pandemic. So this is a relationship which is built on the long-term trust between citizens and the state. And on that information, we had to build our future procedures that we want to adapt to the actual situation. So we had also in that survey, we find out that 94% of the people trusted the guichet.lu or the mygichet.lu portal. So that is a real trust that the people have in the state. This trust has to be built for all the people who are already, let's say, connected. But we have also, as state and as public service, we had also and have to work for all the people who are not really connected. So we have one of the strategic axes of our ministry is the digital inclusion. And during the last year, we worked out a national inclusion plan with 40 concrete measures and actions to help all the people who have perhaps mistrust, who are not as capable as other people, to help them to get in the digital boat. So for to name perhaps a few of the concrete actions, we have skilling programs, reskilling programs, programs for elder people, so train the trainers. We had a collaboration with an organization who organizes courses for the elder people, organizes for the people working with elder people or also with younger people to show them the digital world, that they learn how to handle it. And then we had in the different ministries 40 concrete actions, and I think that will help us in the inclusion of all the people in Luxembourg so that the digitalization can really become a success story.
And moving on to other things that you have inaugurated, GovTech Lab last March, aiming at, as you say, fostering creativity and improving innovation within public institutions. Could you tell us a little bit more about this?
Yeah, the GovTech Lab is, in fact, it's a great idea. We have the IT center of the Luxembourgish government, the CTIE. Together with the ministry, we developed this GovTech Lab. And to summarize it, it is around the three words: innovate, experiment, and to exchange. So we try that the public service exchanges with the private service. We put out challenges. We say, hey, we are the state, we have a solution to find, but there are already solutions out there in the private sector. So this is our challenge. This is the money we put in. Please help us to develop a new product for the public service. I can stress out perhaps two or three initiatives that are actually the actual challenges. We have a Trust My Data challenge where we try to give out really verifiable documents by the state. So to put in, for instance, a certificate for residents in that challenge. Another challenge is a virtual meeting opportunity. So we learned everything about video conferences during the last years, but now perhaps coming back to a real world, people want to have an exchange with the administrations. They can go to the physical counter or they can use a virtual meeting and a virtual appointment with a civil servant. So there we are developing now within a new challenge an opportunity that we can build it in our portal guichet.lu, myguichet.lu, so you can have a virtual appointment with a civil servant. And these are two challenges that I could stress out now. And we have plenty of opportunities. We exchange with startups, we exchange with researchers, we put civil servants in our GovTech Lab. We have also a real lab there where they can meet, that where we can exchange explanations, exchange information, and it works quite great, and I'm really happy that we put it in place.
I think that sounds like a wonderful opportunity, and you're really sitting in the environment. I mean, right behind us is List, and I know that they have fantastic innovators there as well, great science minds.
So I can say this is in fact a really big lab, a future lab, this ICT Spring, and is a really big opportunity for people to exchange, and I find it really great, and it's a nice opportunity to meet again, really to see each other again. I think this is great what they did.
I think so many people are delighted to be seeing one another again this year. It seems to have opened up in the last couple of months. Now, returning to my final question, which is really about next year, it's election year. You've had a very successful number of years so far, but on reflection, tell us about what you're most proud of in your role for digitalization and what you want to achieve before election year.
So I am really proud to have great teams. We built up this ministry. I always called it a ministerial start-up. At the beginning, we had two people working in the ministry. It was the Prime Minister, Mr. Büttel, and myself. Afterwards, we joined 30 people in the ministry, 500 in our IT center, and they achieved really huge goals during the pandemic. I am really proud to have them. We had really pressure. We had a difficult situation, and the state continued to function, and I think that's the most important thing that I have. Great innovators, great people in the ministry and in our IT center. And with all these people, I'm sure that we can achieve everything to innovate, to become really a digitalized world here in Luxembourg. I think we had already big steps. I think compared internationally, we are not bad here in Luxembourg in the e-government part of the digitalization. We created, as we talked about, this GovTech Lab. I think it was a huge step to exchange with the private sector. We had the different ministries being really digitalized, people working and digitalizing everything in the state, and we have to continue. I think it's a never-ending story.
And for next year, what are your hopes in election year? What's your dream job?
I'm doing actually a dream job. I'm the Delegate Minister for Digitalisation. It's a great job. It is a job created by this government when we took office. I think that's the dream job. It would be a pleasure for me to continue.
Minister, thank you so much for your time. As Thanks. A final message, would you like to say anything to all of the digital minds here at ICT Spring?
Stay creative, continue on that way. I think this is the way we have to work. This is what we have to show to the whole world. Be proud of what you do every day and continue to do it. Let's have pleasure while we do the digitalization of Luxembourg.
Minister Hansen, thank you so much for coming here this morning.
Thank you for inviting me. Yeah, great. Thanks.
Thank you.
Bye.